Yeah, I just received this the other day. It's a chamber vacuum sealer. I got it for $300 on eBay. And very impressed with it. So I'll show you somewhat of what it can do. Here's the inside of the unit, and that's what seals the bags. And the nice thing about this is that you know, you can seal liquid bags inside of it without any problem. Not like a vacuum sealer that you normally would use, but yeah, these, and they create a much better vacuum. So anyway, we'll get to it in just a little bit. I've seen a few videos on, but yeah, this is a really nice product, at least so far. I've been probably done already about 30 different vacs of food. I actually took some out that were just packaged, and I broke them apart and resealed them with a vacuum seal. All right, we'll get to it in a little bit. Okay, now you see the ED here. That's what you want to see. That means you're ready to do your vacuum. This you push to set. You see the top one button comes up. That's the time of the vacuum. That's how long you want it to seal. And then this is how long you want it to cool down after it seals the bag. So anyway, I'm going to put in a Mylar bag. A lot of people may wonder. My first attempt did not work because I think I did too long a seal. Although it vacuumed fine, the vacuum released because I think the seal was just... it just got too hot. All right, so we'll vacuum this in just a second. Okay, I got the bag in there. You can see there's a bar. Let me flip this bar. You can flip it back and forth. That's to make sure the bag's held down. You want to make sure it's past this so that you get your seal back far enough. Okay, and you close the lid. And this is hard to do with one hand, but I'm going to start the vacuum. Press down just a little bit till I see the vacuum start to lift. Once that dial starts lifting, you're good. Now we're inside. We got 20 seconds. 15 seconds. You don't see it squeezing because it's the chamber and the bag are all being vacuumed. 8 seconds. 2 seconds, then it will seal the bag. Now it's sealing the bag. Now it's putting the pressure back in. Right now it shows 00, then it goes to ED. Once it comes back to ED, you can lift it up and take it out. You just have to take this out. And you can see that is very well sealed. And that seal is far better than the seal I had before. So the other one I had was, it looked like it was just being pulled apart because it was overheated. In a little bit, I'm going to do some chicken too. All right, I'll be back. Okay, because I am now sealing with 3 mil bag rather than Mylar, I set the sealing for 1.5 seconds instead of 2 seconds because it takes less heat to seal the bag. Bag's up here. Again, you can see that I have it past that bar, and the bar's this bar, and then the other bar is right there. And we'll seal her up. And let's see, let's go here. You see that going up? I can let go now. I don't need to hold it down anymore. And now you'll be able to see it. Got 15 seconds. 10 seconds. 5 seconds. Done. Sealing. I should have showed you this bar coming up. When it seals, it comes up that way. Now it's sealing. It's got 3 seconds to go for the cool down period. And now it's done. Completely sealed. Ready to pull out. When you pull it out, you just pull this bar up and you pull it out. And you're done. That's it. You got a nice seal. This is the Walmart chicken family pack. I decided I want to break them up into 2 breasts at a time. So, all right. Well, I hope you enjoy it. I really like it so far. Longevity, I don't know. But for $300, most of them are like $500 to $900 to $1,000. They're pretty expensive. So this is definitely a good alternative. And it works great. All right. Thank you.